Hey everyone, my name's Braden.
In this video, we're going to go over how to sort a pandas data frame on a single column and also on multiple columns, how to sort a single series within a data frame, and also how to sort a series that is independent of a data frame. So first we'll start off by importing pandas as PD, and then we're going to use data from the website 538, specifically the Women in STEM dataset. Down here, I'm just creating a little bit of missing data so we can have an example of how to sort with missing data.
And we'll look at our data frame real quick.
All right, so we see our data set here has several columns. We're going to be focusing on this major category, total, and share women. This is the proportion of women in that major. Total are the total number of students who responded to the survey. And major category is just that, the category that the major falls within. Let's start off sorting a data frame on a single column. So we can do this by using sort values, and we specify which column we want to sort on with the by argument. So we'll sort on total.
So let's run this and see what we get.
So here we see that we are sorted ascending on our total category. Notice that the missing value is at the very bottom. If we wanted to sort our data frame in descending order, what we would do is say ascending equals false. And now our entire data frame is sorted based on the total column values in descending order. Once again, however, our missing value is at the bottom. If we wanted to change that, we can specify what position missing values come in. So say NA position is equal to first, and this will have all missing values come first and then the values, just like we see here. What we'll want to make sure that we do is, if we want these changes to be permanent, is to specify in place is equal to true.
I don't actually want to keep any changes, so I'm not going to include in place equals true.
If we want to sort our data frame on multiple columns, it's a very similar process. We'll just copy this here and paste it down here. What we'll do is just pass in a list of columns that we want to sort on. You should note that the order that we pass the column names into this list matters. So the column that is in the list first will be sorted by first. So in this case, we want to sort by major category, and then we want to sort by the total. So let's run that and see what it gives us. And here we see that all the major categories are sorted first in descending order. And then we have within these categories, the totals sorted in descending order.
If we only wanted to sort a single column, not the entire data frame, we can do so
by specifying which column of the data frame we want to sort on, then saying sort values, and that will return the series of our data frame sorted. If we wanted to sort a pandas series that is independent of a data frame, we can do that in a similar manner as well. So here I've created a pandas series called capitals, as in capital letters. So here we have A, B, C, and D, both in capital and lowercase. So we'll create that series, and then we state the name of the series that we want to sort. Sort values. What is returned might be a little counterintuitive. So we get all of the capital letters returned first, and then all of the lowercase letters, even though you might expect
that capital and lowercase A would come before either capital or lowercase B.
In order to actually sort in a way that we might have expected, where the A's come before the B's, what we can do is
add the key argument and say
lambda call.str.lower. And when we run this, what this does is first convert all of the string values into lowercase letters and sorts on that.
We should note when we use this method
that it does sort alphabetically, but it doesn't sort based on capitalization. So here A and A come first. That's the position they came in the series. But down here, lowercase c came first,
and then uppercase C, just as they appeared positionally in the series. I hope you found this video helpful. If so, consider giving it a like and subscribing to the channel for future videos related to data analysis and data science. And thanks for watching.